Our business practicum is e-commerce, which involves the selling of product on e-commerce platform. In our case, we will be using platforms such as Shopee to obtain the product to resell, as well as Carousell to market one of our product. We were involved in the service industry. We provided a reselling service. We bundle up a few health and hygiene product obtained from Shopee and resold them. We also sell used items, particularly used iPhones. We use Instagram and Carousell to promote our product. For our Instagram page, we included teaser, soft sell, as well as hard sell. While for Carousell, we focus on hard selling due to the straightforward nature of Carousell. The main reason we chose this platform is because of convenience for both us as seller and buyers out there. Besides, marketing via social media is relatively cost efficient, and the probability of potential customers seeing our product is quite high, as people are always on their phone nowadays due to this pandemic. These are our interactions with our buyers. These are a few feedback from our customer. Generally, we receive an all-around positive feedback from our customer from both the sales of our kits and used iPhones. Despite not making enough sales to make a profit in the health kit department, our service is still considerably good.
This table right here shows the total sales of our health kits from 9 November 2020 to 2 January 2021. On the first week, we managed to sell 3 units for RM62.70. On the second week, we managed to sell 1 unit for RM20.90. This same trend persisted on the following week. On week 4, however, we did not manage to sell any kits at all, and the reason for this will be elaborated further after this. On the fifth week, we managed to sell 1 unit for RM13 this time, and on the 6th week, we managed to sell another 2 units for RM26, and on the 7th week, we managed to sell 3 units for RM39, and on the final week, the 8th week, we managed to sell 6 units for RM78, and this yields a total of RM260.50 in terms of total sales of the health kits. The lack of shipping fees from week 5 to week 8 will be explained further below. Now, on to the total sales of the used iPhones. The first iPhone that we managed to sell was the white iPhone 10, and it was sold on the second week for RM1,400. The second iPhone that we managed to sell was the black iPhone 10, and it was sold on the final week, the 8th week, for RM633. Therefore, the total sales of the used iPhone is RM2,033. Now, onto our pro forma income statement. As you can see below, our revenue is RM2,293.50. After subtracting the cost of goods sold, as well as the expenses incurred, our net profit is RM2,033.59. Now, onto our pro forma balance sheet. On the left-hand side, you can see our current asset, which involves our cash and inventory, and this leads to a total asset of RM2,313.59. On the right-hand side, you can see our owner's equity, which involves our capital and net profit, and this leads to a total equity of RM2,313.59. And as you can see, the left-hand side and the right-hand side are balanced, as all things should be. Now, onto the projected cash flow. As you can see below, the cash on day one, our first day, and the operating activities, which includes sales, represents our cash in, our plus cash. And below that, you can see our cash paid for section, which includes inventory purchase, petrol, and salary, and all of these are our cash out, or in other words, the cash we spent. And after subtracting the cash in and cash out, we get a cash balance of RM2,206.60. And as you can see, this matches the value of the cash on our current asset in the balance form previously. Now, on to the break-even analysis for the health kits. The total cost involved for the selling of the health kits is 346 ringgit and 90 cents. The fixed cost is 50 ringgit. The variable cost is 296 ringgit and 90 cents. The sales price per unit is 13 ringgit. The variable cost per kit is 9 ringgit and 90 cents. Now, with this information, you can calculate the break-even point using the given formula. And after doing so, I obtained the value 16.13. However, I cannot sell 0.13 units to a person. Therefore, that value should always be rounded up. Therefore, I obtained 17 units. And actually, this is what we sold. This is the exact amount that we sold during our sales. Therefore, this means that we did not make any profit, nor did we make any loss. There was no money gained and there was no money lost. Now, onto the break-even analysis for the white iPhone 10. The total cost involved for the selling of the iPhone 10 is 60 ringgit, and it is significantly cheaper than the selling of the health kits because in this case, we don't actually have raw materials. The iPhone is very much pre-owned by us, the sellers. Now, the fixed cost here is still 50 ringgit. The variable cost is 10 ringgit for petrol. The sales price per unit is 1,400 ringgit. The variable cost per unit is 10 ringgit. Now, with this information, I can calculate the break-even point. And after doing so, I obtain 0.04 units. However, once again, I cannot sell 0.04 units to a person. Therefore, that value should always be rounded up. And I obtain 1. Therefore, the break-even unit is 1. And in terms of RM, ringgit, it is 1,400 ringgit. Now, on to the break-even analysis for the black iPhone 10. As you can see here, the total cost, fixed cost, and variable cost is still very much the same. The sales price per unit is 633 ringgit. The variable cost per unit is 10 ringgit. Now, with all this given information, we can calculate the break-even point. And after doing so, I obtain 0.08 units. And once again, I cannot sell 0.08 units, so I round it up to 1. So the break-even point is 1 unit, and in terms of ringgit, RM, it is 633 ringgit.
There are few problems that we have encountered. First is a lack of demand for the health kits from buyers in East Malaysia. The sales of the health kits were entirely from buyers in West Malaysia only. This is due to the difference in shipping fees between West and East Malaysia. The stocks in our inventory were located in West Malaysia, hence West Malaysian buyers got the added benefit of lower shipping fees, even free delivery for those who are in the same district as our sellers. The second problem is the significant decrease in sales throughout the week. During week 4, there was a significant decrease in sales. The reason for the lack of sales in East Malaysia was the restricted movement due to the movement control order imposed that prevented any and all inter-district movement. Third is the high cost of shipping when importing stocks to East Malaysian branch. Since East Malaysia was facing stricter protocols, initially while West Malaysia had slightly less strict protocols, we decided that it would be wise to store all the stocks in West Malaysia to prevent shipping delays. Moreover, we thought that it would be best if we could start selling as soon as possible because we had no initial audience to be able to sell our products in a short amount of time. Next is the declaration of red zones in our seller's district. Halfway through the sales period, the district in which our sellers in West Malaysia resided was suddenly declared as a red zone. For their own safety, they had to stop carrying out their sales. Evidently, in week 4, no sales were conducted. After the situation had died down slightly, they continued their sales. However, after an abrupt stop in sales, customer interaction had halted too. This then made it more difficult to regain their pace. Lastly is the lack of motivation from the sellers. We as students have an overwhelmingly high amount of work to do. We have house chores, assignments, and daily routines to balance, as well as the added task to provide our reselling service.
The fact that we have to conduct our business in this virus-ridden environment makes our lives even more stressful. Moreover, only 1 to 2 sellers in our group have actual experience in selling, while the rest are relatively new to it. This task to sell our products can prove challenging to them. Consequently, this causes a lack of motivation not only in conducting our sales, but in life as well. As for the solutions, we decided to make some promotions such as free shipping for every purchase of our health kit. This promotion was applied in the month of December since mostly businesses will also be doing year-end sales. We also decided to post more frequently on social media from 2 times per week to 4 times per week to regain the pace of our sales. We post mostly during nighttime since most of us are busy during the day with assignments and online lectures. Due to our failure in maintaining the pace in sales, we decided to sell only to the seller's family and close friends to minimize loss. Our sellers also sell to their neighbors since they don't have to worry about shipping the products. We realized at this point we couldn't possibly sell our whole inventory. Therefore, this is our way to minimize our loss. To increase our sellers' experience and motivation to sell, they can take or watch business skills classes since it is easy to access on the internet and some are even free of charge. Moreover, it is adjustable to our busy student schedule. For suggestions, since our products are currently limited to used iPhones and one health kit, we discussed that if we decided to further our business, we should bring in new products and bundle kits so that there are more options on what the customers can choose. Based on our business insights, our branding should also need some improvements since it does not attract that many customers. Hence, we need to discuss more on the design of our logo and social media. As in the current state of our business, only one member is in charge of the financial management. This is quite troublesome since there is so much work to do, such as tracking, budgeting, and planning the financial of the business. Therefore, we should have few members study a bit about finance to help ease the burden. In conclusion, the business could have attracted more attention if our team had spent more time managing the company. While we may have made a profit and exceeded our sales target, it was not from the sales of our health kits. Instead, it was from the sales of the used iPhones. Be that as it may, we are not discouraged by the fact that we could not make a profit out of the health kit sales. Most of us are relatively new to the business world, and we see this as an opportunity to better ourselves as businessmen and women.